What's up, fellas? Welcome back to the channel. Today, we're simulating 2019-2020 college football season for the Texas Longhorns. Let's see how they do. Let's get it. Let's check out the preseason polls. Where are people? Top five, Alabama, Oklahoma, surprisingly Mississippi State, Georgia, and Clemson. Then you got West Virginia, Florida, Miami, Notre Dame, and Michigan in the top 10. And we find Texas at number 18 in the preseason polls. Check out their schedule. They fight the Fighting Charlie Longs, USF Bulls, LSU, Kansas, highly ranked West Virginia and Oklahoma, UTEP, TCU, 22-ranked K-State, Iowa State, Oklahoma State, Baylor, and to close out the year, Texas Tech. That looks like a winnable schedule to me with only a few tough games. Let's see who's doing the Heisman. No Texas people on the Heisman watch. We do have Singletary from FAU. That's interesting. But I think he shows up in a lot of these. Let's check it out. I'll see you on the other side. Here we go. Wow. Danny Allen, 80 overall, defensive tackle. Then you got Travis Anderson, 79 overall, defensive tackle. And Rashard Samuel, 78 overall, quarterback. That's a pretty good class, mid-70s. And then we got a couple low guys here. Martin Rivers, you might never see the field, but kudos to you for following your dream and committing to Texas. Okay, so we have a finalist for the Remington. We have an NCAA record, longest kick return, 90 yards. That's pretty good. Only three consecutive wins, so they didn't quite have the best season. They did sign 3 5-star prospects, and they beat a top 10 team. So that's not the worst. Oh, my God, 7-5. Again, Texas, what are you doing? Let's check out what happened. Conference standings. Kansas State and West Virginia win the Big 12. Texas, let's see, lose to the Fighting Charlie Strongs, but they come back and kill LSU. Then they lose to Kansas. 7-5 Kansas, by the way. Beat West Virginia, beat Oklahoma, beat UTEP, beat TCU, lose horribly to K-State, beat Iowa State, lose to Oklahoma State. That's a close one, only 1 point. Kill Baylor, and then lose to Texas Tech. This Texas team does not know who they are. I don't see a ton of offense in the losses. They must get demoralized. Kansas State and West Virginia, 8-4 to win the Big 12 this year. Oklahoma only goes 6-6, but surprisingly, Kansas goes 7-5. They tie Texas' conference record. Texas does have 263 points against. That's pretty good. That means their defense was on point. That offense, yet again, not getting it done. Wow, that's not great. Check out the top 25. What's going on in the national title race? We see Michigan, 12-0. Surprisingly, Florida, 10-2, number 2. And then we got Alabama, Arizona, Iowa, Stanford, Virginia Tech, South Carolina. That's new. Texas A&M and Washington. We got Michigan playing number 5, Iowa. We got Florida playing number 3, Bama. And those are going to be some pretty good games coming up. We got Tulsa at number 12. We got Hawaii at number 19. And then Ohio State back here at 8-4 at number 20. Houston is SMU, 9-3 apiece. That's pretty good. And Houston was ranked higher before they lost. But let's check out the BCS. Michigan, 12-0, playing number 5, Iowa. Florida playing number 3, Bama. Alabama playing Florida, obviously. Arizona playing number 10, Washington. And Iowa playing number 1, Michigan. That's going to be a great week of games. Scarlett from Stanford leading the Heisman. Can he win it, or does he come in second? Per usual for Stanford running backs. You do see Bradwell from Tulane. That's cool. Really great to see some of those smaller school guys get in on this. Let's check out what happens. Scarlett wins. Wow, Scarlett wins for Stanford. You just don't go into these things thinking that Stanford's going to win, but he had almost 2,000 yards on the ground. 350 reception yards, 21 total TDs. That guy was a beast. Texas is facing 6-6 Penn State in the Meineke Car Care Bowl. Wow. All right. That's an interesting matchup. 6-6, 7-5. Can they win? Let's check it out. Texas wins. They make it to 8 wins, and they won convincingly. Let's check out what happened. Top 25 polls. Let's see who won the national championship just real quick. Michigan, 14-0, 42-18 over number 5, Bama. Wow. South Carolina ends the year 11-2. Stanford, 12-1. Clemson, 11-3. And then Alabama, of course. Let's see if we got anyone interesting down here. Nope, no Texas. So they don't get ranked at the end of the year, but Oklahoma makes it in at number 25. Wow. This is an interesting year to be a college football fan. Check out the conference standings. Obviously, Texas down at 8-5 now. But they win the Meineke Carr Care Bowl. That's a mouthful. 30-21, pretty convincingly over Penn State. Penn State falls to a losing record. But Texas, how do you lose some of these games? You got to be better, especially against USF and Kansas, man. That's pretty freaking bad. I don't even know where. Let's just look at the season stats. So Ellinger only passes for 2,200 yards. That's not going to get it done in the Big 12. Ingram, almost 1,000. 91st in the country. Humphrey, 730 yards. 86th in the country. Townsend, 32 solo tackles, not getting it done. Bimage, 4.5 sacks, no pressure on the defense, apparently. Boyce, 4 interceptions, that's pretty good for a year. And then for the kicking leaders, of course, we got Cameron Dicker coming in at 51 yards. That's not a bad year for a kicker. 20th in the country, but 51's a pretty long field goal. Well, if you stuck around this long, I appreciate you. Comment, like, subscribe, tell me what you think. I'll leave you with this. Texas, 30-21, Penn State. That's it for me. I'm out of here. Deuces.